Hello everybody, I would like to talk about this video, Citizenship by Investment Program in Turkey and the closed districts, an important point in general. These two topics I will combine. As you know, in my previous videos, I explained that there are some districts in Istanbul and in other cities of Turkey as well, from which you cannot take a residence permit. Property residence permit or touristic residence permit or Turkish language course residence permit you cannot take. For example, in Istanbul, Fatih, Esenyurt area, Küçükçekmece, Bahçeli Evler. Now, if you buy a property, even you buy a property about $200,000, you cannot get a property residence permit because the area is closed. In Şişli, for example, Cumhuriyet Mahallesi is closed. If you buy a property from Simpaşkuyun or Rotana, you cannot get a property residence permit. If you buy before this rule, before this the rule which says these areas are closed, you can, if you get already get a property residence permit, as you have a gained right, inherited right, you can continue taking property residence permit. There is no issue on that. This rule does not apply to family residence permit or investor residence permit, which goes to citizenship by investment. If you are planning to make a citizenship by investment program, this rule of closed district does not apply to you. Which means if you buy a property from Şişli Cumhuriyet Mahallesi, from Simpaşkuyun, if you want to apply citizenship, this rule does not affect you. So citizenship by investment program is not affected by the principle of closed districts, closed zones. That is a fact we would like to underline. If you have already taken a residence permit from a closed district and if you make address registration, obviously you can continue using that address for residence permit because you have taken residence permit before this rule of closed zones. That is a really important subject. If you are a student and your university and your house in the same district, which is a closed district, forbidden districts, this rule does not affect you because you are a student. Obviously, it's better to live beside your university, so they accept your residence permit application. For families also, if you live with your husband or wife, even though it's a closed district, you can still get a residence permit from a forbidden district. This is the rule of principle of family unification. I would like to underline this topic because closed regions can be difficult for some of us. But if we are a newcomer, if we want to buy a property, not for citizenship by investment, but for property residence permit, only above $200,000, not for $400,000, you must pay attention to the list of closed districts, forbidden districts. Thank you for watching me. Please stay updated for more videos about immigration and law. Also, I will try to share the list of forbidden zones in this video in the explanation part. Thank you for watching me.